Hi kiddos, it's Riley. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have another video for you all about age regression, but today we are going to be talking about age regression in the context of borderline personality disorder. Now I want to preface this video by saying I am in no way a professional, and a lot of the things that I say are going to be coming from a personal perspective considering I am diagnosed with borderline. So a lot of these are personal experiences that I will be talking about and other general research topics that I have gathered from researching online. So obviously take the things that I say with a grain of salt, do your own research, and talk to professionals over me. These are just things from my own personal perspective and things that I have learned from online research. In addition to being a coping mechanism, age regression can also be a symptom. And in this video, I wanted to talk about age regressing while having a borderline personality disorder or BPD. I also wanted to talk about how age regression affects BPD, how BPD can affect age regression, how BPD can trigger age regression, and some similarities between age regression and borderline. Personally, age regression is a major coping mechanism for myself. During pure regression, it can help me look at things more rationally and without judgment, which is not something that I am usually able to do. Borderline tends to cloud my rational judgment a lot of times and makes me experience a lot of black and white, whereas pure regression helps me see that gray area a little bit better. When I'm experiencing my pure age regression, things like anger and sudden changes don't affect me nearly as much as they do when I am impurely regressed or even in my adult normal headspace when I'm dealing with borderline symptoms. However, on the flip side, my impure regression can be triggered by a borderline episode or vice versa. Intense emotions like anger or sadness can put me into an involuntarily regressed headspace, and that is a pretty common thing with people with borderline, actually. One of the more common ways therapists see age regression in patients is through them regressing when they get angry or when something bad happens through tantrums and things like that. That is one of the most common forms of regression you see in the average person. A lot of borderline symptoms and reactions can be similar to those reactions that children would have in those situations, and those borderline adults can sometimes react in the exact same way that children would to those stressors and events. And being an age regressor, somebody who age regresses whether it's voluntarily, involuntarily, purely, impurely, and also having borderline means that you could experience emotions a lot more intensely than your average person, because not only are you dealing with the symptoms of the mental illness aspect, but then you're also dealing with the intensity emotions of being in a mentally regressed headspace. Because of this, you may feel infantilized, and you may find it hard to maintain interpersonal relationships, even more so than the average adult that has borderline. Black and white thinking is another very common thing that children and BPD folks have in common. So being someone with BPD who also regresses, that can intensify those black and white thinking sometimes, especially during an impure regression episode. But it can also be quite common for regressors without borderline to experience black and white thinking during an impure regression episode for whatever reason while regressed. That's not uncommon. Ultimately, age regression in its healthy and pure form can be a wonderful way to cope with borderline personality disorder. However, it can also be a symptom, and it can be a negative thing sometimes if it is affecting your life in a negative way. So if you feel that age regression is impeding upon your ability to live your daily life, or you feel that it is affecting you negatively instead of positively, that is when I urge you to seek professional help, whether you talk to a therapist or a doctor. There's nothing wrong with that. For the most part, age regression is a wonderful thing, but it isn't for everyone, and that's okay. The important thing is to just remember to take care of you and your health first. I hope this video helped to show you some of the similarities between age regression and borderline. There is a lot more to cover on this topic, but since I am not a professional trained in the subject, I don't feel like it is my responsibility to dive into that more. I don't want to spread a bunch of misinformation. I just wanted to touch on a few basic things, a few things that I have personally experienced being both an age regressor and having the disorder. I will probably make a few more videos like these with other disorders and things that I also deal with, just to provide a little bit of perspective on what it can be like dealing with mental illness and stuff while also being an age regressor, because it can be a really difficult thing. And a lot of people do regress because of mental illness, and I feel like videos like this can be a way to show you guys that you really aren't alone. If you enjoy this video or just want to see more content all about age regression from me, you can subscribe to this channel. I try to post over here a couple of times a week, but if you'd rather keep up with me day to day in between uploads, you can follow me over on Instagram, which is at crayonsandpencils, or over on Twitter, which is at crayonkiddo. I have a Ko-fi, I have a wish list, my merch links are all down below if you want to help support me and my content. It really, really helps me out. It also helps me out if you let the ads play throughout my videos. I love you guys so hecking much, and I will see you very soon. Goodbye.